डॉक्टर पी मुत्तुकुमार एज द चीफ रिसोर्स पर्सन. डॉक्टर पी मुत्तुकुमार वॉज बॉर्न इन तमिलनाडु इंडिया इन 1978. ही रिसीव्ड हिज बीई डिग्री इन इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम द नूरुल इस्लाम कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग इन द ईयर 1999. He received his ME degree in Power Electronics and Drives and PhD degree in Electrical Engineering from Anna University, Chennai in 2005 and 2017 respectively. He is presently working as an associate professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Prasad V. Potluri Siddhartha Institute of Technology, Vijayawada. He has 18 years of diverse experience in the teaching and corporate industry. He is presently a member of IEEE and ISRD. He has authored more than 30 papers published in national and international journals and conference proceedings. Dr. P. Muthukumar regularly reviews papers for IET Power Electronics and IEEE Transactions on Power Electronics. His current research interests include renewable energy sources, power electronics and drives, and VLSI. It is our privilege to welcome you, sir, to this online faculty development program.
A very good morning, sir. Thank you for your introduction nicely. It's a honor to me. I would like to very much thanks for giving the opportunity to present or to contribute in your ATEL work. So we'll directly go to the session or anything else, sir?
We'll start the session, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Then I will present now. You just all the people, can you please check it whether my screen is visible or not? Now I am sharing my screen.
Your screen is visible, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Yes, very good. Very good morning to this session. The topic is multi-level inverter PWM generation for solar PV systems. Okay. So already we all know that why we are going for the solar PV systems, and why we are mainly concentrating for doing the research in solar power. Okay, so in this session, what I am going to do, it is like starts with the solar PV systems, general concepts. Then we'll go for the what are the power electronics side concepts are required to give the quality of the or to get the quality of the power from solar PV cells. Then the next one, that is the importance of the multi-level inverter and the kind of different configurations. So it is a kind of basically what we are working now at present. So that kind of concepts we are I am just to look at that. I'm going to look at that. So we'll do that. The first thing, solar. Based on the solar irradiance, the light energy converted into the electrical energy, and through that some power electronic components, we are going to receive the good power, and we are going to utilize into the AC loads, or we can connect to the grid. So this is the way it is showing like that. Okay, so here also some various technologies we are using, like MPPT and battery systems and inverters and AC power. So these are the things, are different things, concepts we are using. Now, the types of power systems. So what are the general power system types we have actually? So generally classified according to their functional and operational requirements, their component configurations, and how the equipment is connected to other power sources and electrical loads. There, the principal classification is one, we can connect it to the grid. And the second one, we can directly connect it to the standalone load. Okay, so now it's just like a grid connected photovoltaic system. Okay, so here there are two things. So the power we can receive from the PV arrays. Okay, through the power conditioner unit or power conditioning unit, which contains inverters and DC to DC converters and these things. And the second one is the electric utility, that is a grid. Okay, the grid, you just see this direction, that is a bidirectional. Because whenever the solar power is more, that time directly we can utilize that to the AC loads. Whenever it is very less, that time we can use power from the grid. And one more thing, suppose we need more power and we can send to the grid also. Okay, that also possible. This is the generalized grid connected photovoltaic system. Okay, so what about the during night time? During night time we don't have any power, so that time the grid power we can use for the AC load. Say for example, suppose if it is in the standalone system, what are the things are required? Directly we can connect it to the PV array to the DC load. But the thing is, we may not get the good power. We may not get the good power. And one more thing, night time it may not work. So the based on the application we can go. Suppose the application is only working for the daytime, not in the night time, then we can go for this. And at the same time, we are not worrying about the quality of the power. Or like, but basically we should worry about the quality of the power or the maximum power we have to retract from the solar PV arrays. Okay, so this is a standalone one. Then the next one, suppose we have to get the maximum power, that is a very important. And battery side also we have to concentrate, because battery side, if it should not get overcharged. If it is overcharged, then other things will happen. So for that purpose, there is a one more controller, that is a charge controller is required. This charge controller that is used to protect the batteries and the other sources for overcharging, right? Then we can connect from the charge controller also, we can directly connect it to the DC load. And from the battery means, suppose our load is AC load, what we have to do? So if it is in the AC load, better thing is we have to convert AC into DC, sorry, DC into AC. So in that purpose, we are going to use one more power electronic component that we call it as an inverter. Okay, so from the inverter side, we can concentrate more. So end with the multi-level inverter only. Okay, now say for example, if it is in the hybrid system, so hybrid system, PV array, charge controller are connected, DC load. Then what about this? Actually, the wind turbine, it can generate like AC it might generating. Then what we need actually, suppose we want to store the power. So we need the rectifier. Rectifier that is used to convert AC power to DC. Then we can connect to the battery. Okay, this everything is a centralized system is required. Then battery, the output we can go to the inverter. And one more thing, suppose we have the AC load. Okay, then we can directly connect with some provisions we have to give. Based on that, we can connect to the AC load. Okay, what is the wind turbine? Those areas, whenever the wind power is there, that is whenever the air is there, then that time, whenever wind is there, then that time the output will give the maximum power. Okay, these are the important generalized concepts. And the charge controller, as I told, is a set of circuit to protect the battery from overcharging. And one more thing, MPPT controller is used to suck the maximum power from the PV arrays. Then typical MPPT controller, how it is actually. So the PV panel is connecting, that is a current and voltage, it is connecting to the boost controller. Okay, the MP, based on the MPPT, this is like a controller, controller. So this will generate the on and off duration to the DC to DC boost converter power semiconductor switches. Okay, based on that this will act as a boost controller. Okay, and it will give the voltage, maximum voltage to the that is used to help to the battery charging. Okay, then now we are going for the concepts, that is our inverter concept. Okay, so inverters basically that is used to convert DC power into AC power. Okay, so here what are the things are there? First thing is whatever the work or whatever the application we are doing, some performance matrices, or we can say as a performance indices. Okay, the only very important performance indices is a total harmonic distortion. Total harmonic distortion. is a measure of the harmonic distortion present in a signal. The meaning is what? The AC output, that is an inverter output, should be as much as possible, should be as a sine wave. This sine wave, we have to give it to the any AC load. Say, for example, induction motor, three phase or single phase or whatever the motor we are connecting in the AC load. If it is in the pure AC, then what will happen? If it is in pure AC, then there is no other losses occur in the motor side. Okay, so if losses occurs, it will finally convert it into heat and the heat will produce. Okay, so here that performance indices are very much important. See, given in our home system also, we are connecting all the AC loads. Okay, so there also we are in the supply side, they are checking the individual home, whether they are their individual harmonics or how it is performing and everything they are monitoring. If it is in beyond that limit, definitely our EB, electric board people, they will come and they will alert us. Okay. Now, what is the formula? Generalized formula is the THD, total harmonic distortion, is the V2 square, square root of V2 square plus V3 square plus V4 square divided by the V1. V1 is the fundamental voltage, which has the fundamental frequency. In our system, in India, in our system, we may have the 50 hertz supply that we are telling as a fundamental. Okay. Now, there are few things. One is two-level inverter and another one multi-level inverter. One is two-level inverter, another one multi-level inverter. Oh, then first we are going to see that two-level inverter in the MATLAB. Then the drawback we will analyze step by step. Then we'll go for the multi-level inverters. Okay. At the end of the session, we will discuss in the query session also. Okay, people may have some queries. At the end of the session, we will look at that. Then two-level inverters. Okay, see, this is actually this is a MATLAB diagram for the two-level inverter. Okay, the output will be either positive or negative, either positive as well as the negative. Then only we call it as a AC. Okay, then we'll go for the MATLAB. Simple two-level inverter, I would like to see that. I will show that. Okay, look at that diagram. So this is a two-level inverter. Here our AC, how much voltage I have given? Nearly 100 volt. 100 volt I am giving here. Okay, so load, what about load? Load I am just mentioning 10 ohms just I am mentioning during a positive half cycle. So I need the positive half cycle. So this switch as well as this switch will conduct. This switch as well as this switch will conduct. So the AC power will go and connected here, and we'll get the finally we'll get the DC power. So I will run this value. I will run this MATLAB. So look at that. The output will be, look at that. So the last one, this is the voltage. This is the voltage. Okay. So it is a DC value, 100 volt we have provided. So this one during the positive half cycle, 100 volt. During negative half cycle, minus 100 volt. So we can say as a AC. But this is not the pure. This is not the pure AC. Okay. There are certain harmonics are there. How to check their performance? We have the one more tool called power GUI. Okay, we have one more tool called power GUI. So from here, tools, FFT analysis. From the FFT analysis, that is a fast Fourier transformation, this analysis, we can able to find out the individual harmonics as well as the overall harmonics also, we can see that. So scope data input is third one. You just look at that. It's a, like a square wave, okay, square wave. One cycle I'm measuring. See, look at that, nearly 48.03% total harmonic distortions are there. Actually, in our electrical system, the THT, as much as possible, it should be very less. It should be very less. Here, I am measuring like a voltage. This is like, this is the voltage harmonics. Okay, some people, they may look into the current also. So current means what I will get like that. Same I am getting, because here I am not using any L load, only R load only I am using. I have not used any kind of filters also. Okay, only just a two level inverter, half single phase two level inverter just designed and done that. But the fundamental and these things, look at that, very, it is a 123.7 volt. Here there are options are there. List, if you are doing the list, you just look at that. What about, this is very important, third order harmonics is 33.33%, and the fifth order harmonics 19.99%. Actually, in the third, fifth, that is the odd order harmonics. That is the odd order harmonics. These are very much dangerous for the dangerous to the loads, especially for the induction motor loads or other loads. So how much percentage, how we are going to reduce, this is a very important. So how we are going to reduce, either we have to use the filter, or point number two, we have to go for the multi-level inverter. This is the first point. Okay, some more other options also, we'll see that. This is just a two-level inverter. Okay, here the thing is, this is two-level, that is okay. Any other methods are there? Yeah, one more method, we call it as the PWM method. Or generally, this is a very important thing, is there is a sinusoidal pulse width modulation inverter, SPWM. Generally, we can say as a SPWM. So how we are going to do with the SPWM? It is a very simple comparison thing. So this is for SPWM, wait. So this harmonics we are getting for 45 and these things. Okay, we'll go for the SPWM. See here, first I will show the waveform, carrier and generation waveform. Actually, we can divide it into two groups. One is carrier based PWM, another one carrier less PWM, whatever, either two level or multi level, whatever it is. Okay, the first one which I am showing, like it is a carrier less PWM, directly we are generating the gate pulse. Okay, here carrier, how carrier and reference we can use, and comparing it and generating the PWM. Okay, by comparing this sine and triangular, yeah, I am comparing this. Just I will put one more. Okay. Will be, this is for sine. This is another sine, another output. This one is another output. I would like to run only one cycle, so I can say I will run the only one cycle, then we can see easily identify. Look at here. So triangle also I can show here, right? Just connecting this triangle. See here, this triangle and this sine wave compared, and the PWM has been generated, and the PWM has been generated. Okay, so suppose I want to all in one, that also possible. So here in MATLAB, there are a lot of options are there. We can change the waveforms, and how many waveforms are required. That also we can do it. Now, you see here. Sorry, the triangle which I need. See triangle, you just look at that, these two things, look at that, then based on that this pulse has been generated. Okay, how can I suppose I want to you lay out? Look at that. So based on this intersection point, this is important. See, actually, what is the benefit of the sine PWM? The pulse width gradually increased. This is very important. If the pulse width is gradually increased, then what will happen? Certain harmonics will be moved to the higher order level. You have to look at that. Earlier one, we have seen that the harmonics are in third order harmonics, fifth order harmonics are available. It is a lower order harmonics. We can say it is a lower order harmonics. So if we want to eliminate the lower order harmonics, so what is the very important thing is the bulk amount of filters I have to use, then only I can eliminate those kind of harmonics. So how can I just to do it in other way? Just I can go for pulse width, I can change it, then accordingly what will happen, the harmonics which will appear around the switching frequency. So here the switching frequency is around 1 kHz. Switching frequency is 1 kHz. Then our major harmonics will appear around the 1 kHz. But even though that also very important. So we should avoid that also. Okay. Now we'll look at that. How to see this, the harmonics. Look at, no, this is not. Wait. Some certain settings also we have to look at, then only we can able to get there, because so many files I have generated, so accordingly we have to see carefully, because some output we may not get, some output it may be give the some other file, so accordingly we have to see this output. This parameter also we have to see carefully. This parameter, single simulation output. If it is in clicked, it is very tough to get the one. I will run once again. Wait, the name which I want to found this one, which I need actually, this one I need. Here it is, the voltage. Okay. Oh, here I have used the filters. Okay. Yeah. At the initial, what I will do, I'll just make it zero. So, take a minute. Now I have removed the L and C filters. So what is going to happen? We'll see that. Okay, this is pure sine. Okay, here voltage and current. This is the voltage which we are getting. Okay, this is the voltage which we are getting. This is the current. Okay, accordingly we will see that graph. What's the name? the name which we are giving, this is the logging name, scope data one, this is the third input. Okay, so scope data one, third input. Okay, look at that. Now we'll see the harmonics. The start time, it's a only one cycle only. Okay. So here you just look at that, the THT, it is nearly same, but if the harmonics are moved, the harmonic percentage, look at that, lower order harmonics are very less, only 4%. Earlier one, that is a nearly the 33%. Okay, now we'll go. So these can be overcome or little bit can contribute to the filters by using filters. Now I will show the we'll go here. So this we have seen. So the waveform corresponding voltage and these things we are getting. But here the important thing is the harmonics appear at a very low magnitude. The lower order harmonics magnitude is very low level. Okay, this is for if you are using L and C. Our output voltage somewhat sinusoidal, but this also not sinusoidal purely. But because the selection of the L and C is a very important thing. Okay, it will dragging to another research area. Then, so here you can look at that. The THT is very less, but at the same time fundamental also very less. So then we have to see. So how to create these things? That we will see on some other time. Okay, now. Suppose with the filter in some values of L and C, random values of L and C, we are getting the nearly one. But this also is not good. This also not good. So here we are getting the 14.93% THT. Okay. How we can achieve the same kind of things without using filter? Okay. That is our major ambition, because filter cost is more, and also the size of the filter is, it will occupy the major portion of the in the entire inverter setup. Now, okay, now drawbacks I told. Then one more important point: if you are going for the two level inverter, what we have to do, we have to go for the high switching frequency. Okay, then only we can, the harmonics will move to the higher order level, point number one. Then what about the switching loss? Definitely, obviously, if the switching frequency is more, the switching losses also will be more. Switching losses also will be more. So how to avoid it? The entire answer will be our MLI, that is a multi-level inverter. Okay, so how to achieve? The earlier one, only the two-level inverter I said. The two level, that is, one is a positive level, another one negative level. Okay, how to do in the multi-level? That we are going to see that. Okay. The definition, a multi-level inverter is an inverter having power semiconductor elements which is capable of providing desired alternating voltage with multiple level at the output using multiple level DC voltages. There are a few things are there. Okay, either single DC source we can use, and we can convert it into multiple level. That is by using one set of MLI classification. Okay, then what are the, I will tell you what are the classifications. The classifications, there are three. Diode clamp MLI, this is the major classification I'm telling. Diode clamp MLI, capacitor clamp MLI, and a cascaded H-bridge based MLI. Apart from diode clamped MLI as well as capacitor clamped MLI, too many components we are using, many diodes we are using. Okay, and a capacitor. Okay, capacitor also, too many capacitors we have to use, and these things are there. So these are the certain drawbacks. So in my research, what I am looking, it's only is based on the cascaded H-bridge is somewhat better than others. Cascaded H-bridge based work. Okay, so apart within the cascaded, how many H-bridges we have to use to get the MLI? Okay, there are few classifications are there. There are few classifications. Either multiple H-bridge we can use to get the multiple levels. Okay, that is a one. Second one, single H-bridge, but we can get the multiple level without using any major components. Okay, that we are going to see. Here we are going to do in the two kind of levels. One is 31 level and another one 7 level. Okay. So already I told this cascaded H bridge is very easy to implement and compared with any other multi-level inverter. There are two PW methods. One is already carrier based MLI and carrierless MLI. We can classify. Okay. And based on the source also, we can classify into two groups. One is symmetrical MLI and another one unsymmetrical MLI. Symmetrical MLI and unsymmetrical MLI. In our research, what we are using to do, basically, I am somewhat good at in the FPGA side. So what, whatever the PWM, so FPGA also I will generate and MATLAB also I will generate. Okay. So, but in the real time point of view, I am preferring the FPGA side. Not in like something is possible in the MATLAB also. Directly we can do some work in the MATLAB and from the MATLAB itself run to the generating the PWM pulses. System itself generating the PWM and via the some ports and we can give those PWM signals to the gate of the each and every IGBT or MOSFET. Each and every IGBT or MOSFET. See, okay, one more thing. Okay, when we have to go for MOSFET or when we have go for the IGBT, so suppose if the switching frequency is very high, then we can go for the MOSFET. And the second thing, cost also a very important constraint. Suppose we want to do in the very less cost one, then we can go for the MOSFET. Other areas, we can go for the IGBTs. Okay, now DC source is connected, and MLI connected, MLI output connected to the load. Here, I would like to show the simple thing by using the only R load. Okay, now see here, this is the generalized structure. This is the generalized structure. H bridge 1, H bridge 2, H bridge 3, and H bridge 4. H bridge 1, H bridge 2, H bridge 3, and H bridge 4. Okay, here the solar PV, suppose the solar PV 12 volt is giving here. Second H bridge, that is a 24 volt. Third one, it is a 48 volt. Here I am making like a asymmetrical level. I am making this in asymmetrical level. In this case, we can connect it to the any kind of load. But here I am showing only the R load outputs. Okay, each and these four H bridges will contribute or will either generating the power sent to the load or no. Okay. During the positive, if the positive half cycle is required and the certain levels are required, then these will conduct. Okay. If the negative voltage is required, if the positive is required, 1 and 3 will conduct. If the negative is required, 2 and 4 will conduct. Likewise, these things. But the voltage level, the contribution voltage level, you have to understood, the first H bridge will contribute 12 volt, second one 24 volt, third one 48 volt, fourth one 96 volt. Now the question. Sir, then how many levels maximum is possible? Definitely maximum is possible. You just look at that, the ratio of the voltage, here 12, here 24, here 48, here 96. So 1:2:4:8, am I correct? So in this way, how many totally, if you are adding like all the voltages divided by 12, then you will get the 15. So in the positive side 15 level and the negative side 15 level you will get. Okay. Otherwise, how can we see? You look at that switching angle. This is alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 4, up to alpha 15. This is only the positive side. Okay. So I am just mentioning this is in the this is the alpha means this is 180 minus alpha. Simply I am mentioning. Okay. In the negative half cycle, the same thing will repeat. But opposite switches will act. Say for example, I need the first level. What I will do? Only IGBT 1 and 3 will be on. Remaining all the switches will be off. Okay. Then I need 2. This level I need. That is a 24 volt. Then what I have to do? I have to turn on only this. Not even this also switch off. Only this 5 and 7 will be on. If 3 means along with 5 and 7 and 1 and 3 will also be on. 1 and 3 also on. 5 and 7 and 1 and 3. Okay. Say for example, I need 11. I need 11th level. Okay. What I have to do? 11th level. Okay. So first we have to add this. So 15 here 1 plus 2 plus 4, how much is 7? Then this one, 7, this one will give the 8. So I need 11, then total 8 will take here and the remaining 4 will come, right? Remaining 4 will come. So if you are adding these two, then we'll get the obviously. Okay. So likewise, we can view and we can get. Now, I would like to compare the switching angle. Just here, we are just assigning the constant switching angle. Constant switching angle. If I'm providing the constant switching angle, that we are going to see. Then we'll see the what is the drawback of that. That also we are going to see. Okay. If you need the constant switching angle, the total duration is 180 degree. Okay. 180 degree for the per half cycle. Okay. Then 90 degree, that 90 degree duration is 0.005 millisecond. Correct? I can say 5 millisecond. So that divided into 15, and equally given. Okay. Accordingly, it is running. Suppose I need the 15 level. What I have to do? Alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 5. So accordingly it has to play. Okay, then we can just make it a double, then we'll get. Then if it is in 7 level, that also possible. Only 1 level, that also possible by using the 4 H bridges. We can avoid one H bridge one by one. Automatically we'll get all those levels. Okay, this is a typical FFT analysis 31 level output. Look at that. I will show in MATLAB also. See here, the four H bridges are connected here. Okay, the voltage is here 98 volt. This is the fourth H bridge. This is third. This is second. This one is the first H bridge. Okay, here I will run that accordingly. PWM generator, I will run it first. I will run in two cycles. 0.04. Okay, I will run in two cycles. Look at that. We are getting the tool. We are getting, this is the voltage, this is current. Okay. Then R also we have to see. What is the R value here? 10 ohms. Okay. So the output is like this. Okay. What is the THD which we are getting? We have to go here and we have to look at that. Now, the THD which we are getting 14.48%. Same as without filter I am getting, but the levels are increased. But even though this is somewhat huge, this also somewhat huge. For 31 level, it can be somewhat 7 or 8, it is better. Okay, that we'll see some other approaches are there. Okay, we'll go. Now, this is for 31 level. How can I go for the 15 level? Very simple. This first H bridge I will remove. The first H bridge I will remove. I remove, then open. I have removed that one. Enough. See here, only 3 H bridges are there. Okay, only 3 H bridge, 98 volt, 48 volt, 24 volt. I will run this. So 5 cycle, maybe 0.1 means 5 cycle. 5 cycle it is running. Now you just look at that. So we'll get, okay, neatly we are getting the output. Now, oh, what is the harmonics which we are getting? For 15 level we are getting, look at that, this is 15 level. How much? 17.54 we are getting. Okay. Now, we want to check the current. That also possible. 17, same, but 13.98 amps. Okay. Now, we'll go for the 7 and the 3rd also. 7 and the 3rd also will get like that. Now, we can compare. Okay, now this is for 147. This is our typical setup in our college. Here this board, that is the FPGA board, very small FPGA board. By using, we can run that. Okay, so totally, how many 16 IGBTs we have used? 16 MOSFET, sorry, MOSFET we have used. So this is for amplification as well as the isolated PWM generated from here, and the PWM generated sent from here to here. Then output we are measuring this device, and actually in our setup we are not using the any solar we are not using, but some other setup we have used in the practical also. Okay. So in FPGA side, the PWM generated by using the VHDL language, that language, yeah, simulated by model sim and synthesized by Xilinx FPGA and downloaded into the processor via another small software is there, then doing all those things. Then look at that, this software, and we are getting this output also. Now you look at here also we are getting the output, and like in DSO also we are getting the output. Now what is the value of THD, and we can compare for various levels, 31 level, 15 level, 7 level, and 3rd level. Okay, 3 level. Okay, look at that, the THD you can compare. But this is only I am doing R and RL load. R and RL load, almost nearly same. Based on the L value, okay. So THD 14.2 THD. If I am decreasing the level, the THD is increased. And the fundamental also, look at that. Fundamental also decreased. Okay. Now, what is the observation? If the number of levels increased, then THD will be reduced. If number of levels are increased, then magnitude of higher order harmonics are reduced. Look at that. Magnitudes of higher order harmonics will be reduced. The lower order harmonics are also dominated in less number of levels. That we have to see. Okay. Now, these are the things are okay. So even though this output, it is not similar to the sine wave. Okay. So that is the problem. Then how to do that? So these things we can overcome by using the carrier based MLI generation. Carrier based MLI generation. How to do that? Very easy way. The carrier based, and one more, I would like to take the another configurations, not in cascaded H bridge or multiple H bridge. Here I am using only one small H bridge, and here the voltage is like a symmetrical, not in asymmetrical. Okay, asymmetrical means if the all the voltages are equal, then we can say as a asymmetrical. But here all the voltages are equal. Okay, because a different configurations we have to approach, then we can come to know the final conclusions. Okay, here how many switches we have used here? 4 plus 3, 7 switches. 4 plus 3, 7 switches we have used. and three diodes we have used. Now, how it is working? So compare the earlier one. This is I can easily explain. Okay, this is overall switch as well as the source are connected, but the source, three sources we have connected, all are equal sources. Source and connected serially with another one IGBT. If the IGBT is connected, only this IGBT is connected. What will happen? Connected, and the this will be connected here, and this will go. This will get forward biased. These two diode will get forward biased and going here. Now, during the passive half cycle, Q1 and Q4 will conduct. Here I named it Q1 and Q4. And during negative half cycle, Q3 and Q2 will connect. These two will conduct. Okay. Now, what is happening? Mode 1 operation, that is the first level. Maybe this is the first level I am saying. This first level, this one is conducting. Okay. Then this diode 1, diode 2, and here it is conducting. The red color mark I have mentioned, that is for the current direction. Okay. Now, mode 2. So what I have to do? Whenever I need to turn on this switch, that time, this is the way. Or whenever I need the level 1, that time, this will has to turn on. Then this will conduct. Okay. Now, mode 2. How to do the mode 2? Here, this mode 2, S1 and S2 will conduct. S1 and S2 will conduct. Then accordingly, the current flow is going here. Then this will run. Okay, this is for mode 2, but in positive. Mode 3. All the three switches are turned on. Then the entire voltage, maybe we may define it for 12 volt. Then 36. Okay, all the voltages will apply. Okay, then mode 4. This is in the negative side. This is in the negative half cycle. Q3 and Q2 will conduct. See the current direction. And this is for mode 5. This is for mode 6. Now, what is the seventh level? That is the zeroth level. Okay, now we understood how the switches are turned on and turn off. Now, how to improve the PWM by using the carrier. Here, I can say that three kind of modulation methods. One is phase disposition, and another one phase opposition disposition. Third one, alternate phase opposition disposition. What is that actually? Very simple. First, this is the simple waveform. First, I would like to tell. This is the simple waveform. We are comparing triangle and sine wave. Okay, whenever the sine is major, is more than the triangle, then that one switch will turn on. See here, this is the one comparing here. If the sine is more, then the top switch, when we need actually the top level switch will on. Whenever we need the second one, the same kind of things will happen. Comparing this triangle with this one, then immediately turn on the second switch. Then what about this? Whenever high, that time second one will happen. Okay, now see, actually this output up to this, it is like a only DC. Up to this only DC, but the inversion operation happens. The meaning is what? This is a multi-level DC output. Here, up to this point, I am telling these two point. Okay, up to this, before the inversion, it is a multiple level DC. Okay, after that, the inversion, these four switches will come into play and that will do the inversion operation. Look at that. Okay, we'll show the output, then I will explain. See, here, this is our output. This is our voltage output. Okay, now we'll go, come. Yeah. What is phase opposition? Phase opposition means all are simultaneously starts from zero, or it is like a rising. It is like a rising, I can say. Okay, both positive side. This is a positive side actually. This is the positive side. This will be the negative side. Okay. What about a phase opposition disposition? See, look at that. See here, all the carrier signals above the zero are out of phase with those below the zero by out of phase. Both, this is the first half cycle, this is second half cycle. Sorry, second half cycle, that is a below one. Both are in opposite phase. Both are in opposite phase. Otherwise, I will, by comparing another way also. This is like all the adjacent carrier signals are out of phase by 180 degrees. Okay, look at that. This is another 180 degrees. Okay, likewise also we can clarify. Now, so this way also, see, look at that. This is actually the original one. This is actually the original one. So during positive half cycle, that will compare that this one. Negative half cycle, this one, it will compare. Okay. So when it is started, this is for PD. This is for POD. This is for APOD. Okay. Given. Now, okay, one more thing. The performance parameter already we have seen. That is a total harmonic distortion. That is a total harmonic distortion. Now, how to do that? This by THT already we are measuring that. Okay, if you want to take all the individual harmonics, that also possible. All the individual harmonics, that also possible in the MATLAB. Okay, then one more parameter we call this a weighted total harmonic distortion. Weighted total harmonic distortion, WDHD. Okay, is a commonly used expression to assess the quality of pulse width modulated inverter. Here you just understood pulse width modulator inverter. Okay. Yeah, it will give the individual weightage of the WDHD. It will give the individual weightage of the WDHD. 1 by W1 square root of Vn by Vn the whole square. Okay. So here we have to take the individual harmonics. That we have to see at the end. If we have the time, then I will show how to take the individual harmonics also. Okay. Then harmonic. One more point, there is a harmonic spread factor. Why this is required? Actually, if you are doing the single phase, then okay, if you are doing it other than the induction motor load, no issues. But if the load is in the induction motor load, single phase or three phase, then one more point also we can we have to look into that. What is that actually? Generally, we may get the motor sounds when we are running, whenever or whatever the situation. If you are running the induction motor, what will happen? It will give the some sounds. What are the primary sources? As per my understanding, I'll tell you. What are the primary sources of the sounds? There is a one is mechanical construction. Simply, I can say mechanical construction. Second one, air turbulence. Air turbulence. So air turbulence in the sense, maybe because of the air, it will give some sounds. Second one. Third one, our input voltage. Our input voltage. This is also very important parameter. Our input voltage in the sense, input of the inverter voltage, input of the induction motor voltage, or output of the inverter voltage, or output of the inverter voltage. Okay, now how to do that? Okay, so this also we can calculate as much as possible. This HSF value is less, then the motor will be the noise will be less as per the theoretical things. Okay, now how to, as per POD, PD, then the some simulation output, I would like to show that based on the carrier. Here also we can, one more point we can add. The carrier triangle frequency, it may have the 1 kilohertz or it may have the random frequency also, that is possible. Okay, now, see that this is the 7 level. This is the 7 level. Output here we are generating the PWM and sending to the each and every IGBTs, each and every IGBTs. Okay, now we'll run, then we'll see that. Then this is the PWM pulses. This PWM pulse, it will run for the 50 hertz. This will run for the 50 hertz. So as I told, positive half cycle, these two things will connect. Negative half cycle, these two things will connect. Okay, this is for the level decider. I can say these switches or these PWMs for the level decider. Okay, for comparison, and it will show that output also some scope. Okay. Now look at that. Okay. See, these are the switches and it is connecting. What is the first we have to check the voltage? 12 volt. What about here? 12. What about here? So it is a symmetrical. It is a symmetrical MLI. This is a symmetrical MLI. So here PWM also generated one waveform also. It is run that. Okay. I will run now. I will run now. Okay. Don't it is a only sine wave. But finally, it will give the proper one. Okay. Each and every sine wave will get like that. Sine, and it is finally we are getting this output. We will look at. Okay, here we are getting the values. So the people sometime people are counting from top. Okay, so I'm also counting from the top. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, totally 7 level. In the top one, it is a multiple on and off durations are happening. Multiple on and off durations are happening. You just look at that. In the two level inverter, if the frequency is more, the obviously the number of on and off duration, number of switching also more. So switching loss will increase. Here it is not like that. Only one, if one cycle happening, so the turn on of that particular switch is very less. Say here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 only. But accordingly, suppose if I want to decrease the modulation index, definitely the amplitude also will decrease. Okay. That also possible. Okay, how to achieve that? The previous constant switching frequency, we have to deal with the other way. But here, just if you are changing the modulation index, it definitely will reduce the harmonics. Okay, now I want one more. Yeah, look at that. You just look at that. This graph. Okay, I will run only 2 seconds, two cycles. I will run. See here, 2 cycles I run it. Okay, here the crossing is 1. Here also crossing is 1. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Something, so many turn on and turn offs are happening. Now, suppose if I am reducing, this is the modulation index 1. Suppose if I am reducing, what I have to do? Very simple way. This sine amplitude just 0.8. Here, both. This is a modulation index. Just I am changing for this carrier. I am running this. Then now look at that waveform. Now look at that waveform modulation index 0.8. So 0.8, definitely the number of turn on and turn off will be very less. So accordingly, the T gauge T. See here, the meaning is what? The portion of the voltage which we are getting from the corresponding source, it's reduced. Is reduced. Okay, so that we are getting like this. The voltage, we have to go for how much AC power we are getting. Go for the FFT, fast Fourier transformation. This is, look at that. We are getting only the THT will increase 26%. Here 24.96 voltage. Okay, this is for the modulation index 0.8. If I'm making like 0.1, earlier I didn't check. So 1 I'll make it here again. So 26 volt we are getting, right? Now I am running this. Okay, here we are getting now. See, look at that. Fundamental voltage is increased. Okay, if the modulation index 1. See, this is actually 32 volt. So fundamentally is increased and the THD also increased. So as per earlier theoretical formula, if modulation index is increased, fundamental also will increase. Okay, this is true for both the sine PWM or space vector pulse width modulation, or else whatever the PWM methods. If the modulation index is increased, then fundamental also will increase. Then what about the THD point of view? If modulation index is increased, then THD will be decreased. Okay, this is true. Okay, how to get this value? Here we have list this value. Okay, suppose here we have the certain parameter like a property something, it is there. Actually, the working with here property editor we have. If you are clicking this, then one more property tool will open, graphic tool. This property editor, actually the working with the MATLAB tool itself, we have to learn so many things. In the graph itself, we can edit. Okay, it will come. Before that, we'll see some other points. Okay. This is the triangle input. So triangle input fixed frequency 18.22, which we are getting now. Okay. So what is that? With the POD configuration, that is a PD configuration. This is POD configuration. We are getting a 20.11. Okay. This is for like this will be like which configuration? A POD configurations with 1 kHz switching frequency. And another one. This is a random frequency, 1, 2 kHz, randomly switching. What is happening? That also possible. We can change the triangle frequency also randomly. So randomly, then it is switching. So automatically, the one more parameter, we call it as a HSF, harmonic spread factor. That will decrease. Okay. Property inspector. Taking some more time, wait. Okay, this is for POD. Yeah, we are getting the property inspector. Look at that. This is important. Okay. See, here we are not getting the value, right? So reason, what is that? Okay, 1 minute. I will run once again. Okay, so I'll click once again, then Okay, leave it. It will come. If you are using the repeated tools and these things, we can able to find out those values. Okay, now. Now we'll see here the result. We can analyze the result where we are getting the maximum value and these things. The fundamental voltage, like this also possible. Okay. Then here, fundamental 32.11. Okay, actually the overall voltage which we are giving, it's like a 36. Okay, then the THD is 20.53 for APOD. But at the same time, WDHD 1.71, HSF 0.61. Okay, PD is also okay. Now, this is the critical setup which we have experienced in the earlier college. Okay, so here, In my research work, all the research, it is based on the FPGA-based MLI or FPGA-based inverters. Okay, this side, I am very much interested, so I am doing those things also. Okay, then one more point, the concept which we have discussed and those things. This book is a very good, important book. Advanced DC and AC Inverters, Applications in Renewable Energy. This author has given the good book, actually. So you may get the soft copy also. This will be analyzed from the first level to up to the maximum level, even some level of 200, 300, 301 level. What is the output? How much THD we can achieve maximum? These things they have given. Then one more thing, that is asymmetrical, I told, right? So in that asymmetrical, what I have mentioned the voltage level is 1:2:4:8 ratio. But in some configurations, they have mentioned 1:2:9, like that also they have designed. Actually, the nearly more than 100 or more than 500 different kind of MLI configurations are available. Okay, in what case they are improving? There are a few primary cases. One is like a THD point of view. Second one, the number of switches should be less. Okay, number of switches should be less. Third one, the generation of PWM. Should not be much complicated. So in this way only the people are research are doing and everywhere. Okay, then any other things like PWM, and at present my current research is 31 level and 7 level MLI for a different kind of configuration. One is H-bridge based and another one series switches and some other things, series or parallel switches. So here this. This switch, I will show that. This switch actually is series switch as well as the sources are series. Okay, but ulta also possible. Right, this switch we can place it here. Okay, this also possible. So accordingly, we will get some kind of improvements. We will get. Okay, any other doubts, or we can go. Any other simulation is required. So now it is you can ask any doubts.
Participants, you can ask the doubts either through directly or through chat box.
First, if multiple people, it is tough, right? So better chat box also is okay. I can see the chat box also. I can see the chat box also. Okay, thank you.
So if you don't have any doubts, we can conclude the session. So Professor, thank you very much for the wonderful, nice and informative sessions handled by you today. So really, because for the past previous classes, we had gone through the research areas with respect to mechanical engineering department. We have few electrical and electronic based participants also. So okay. For their convenient, we arranged a session which is related to somewhat electrical engineering. So multi-level inverter for solar PV applications. Really, the session was very nice. And I know that during this time, you were a busy schedule, you are having the online classes and other research activities, what you are dealing with the institute. You just accepted our request and you delivered the nice session here. So we are very much grateful to you on behalf of Jyoti Engineering College. Yes, we enjoyed the session a lot, and we expect your support in our upcoming events and upcoming conferences and other programs also.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Professor. So thank there you, is one question.
I would like to thanks to the management for